So I've done a lot of work in autonomous systems. It started in deep space, right? And where, you know, about $500 million is at stake, you're kind of uncertain about what could happen. There's the issues of risk. The reason why autonomy was driven was because operating these from a human standpoint became challenging, but then adding in autonomy makes it really, really challenging as well. The lessons that we learned from controlling autonomous spacecraft then carry over into the whole range of other kinds of autonomous systems that for example, the Volpe Center needs to deal with in terms of air surface vehicles, shipping, and the likes. And so the 20 years that I've been at MIT, we've been trying to broaden what we learned there, broaden this to a whole range of transportation contexts. What I wanted to try to do was to talk about two issues that have been central for us in autonomous systems, right? Which is being able to provide systems that are assisting you, right? So rather than it doing something autonomously, right? People need to do the tasks. There are things that people are really good at, but you want to be able to help them deal with the overload of the situation, right? By helping them in the decision-making process. And that could be monitoring, it could be reminding you of things, it could be keeping your attention on the road, it could be planning contingencies. Right? So that as a collaborative decision-making process is one theme. And then the second theme that's important to us is the issue of safety. And often we end up making decisions, right, which are a bit too risky. And so we would like to have systems which can kind of help us to make sure that we're not doing things that are too risky. When you start dealing with safety, right, then you want the system to be able to understand, one, what is the notion of safety, right? So if the world is uncertain, then you can't guarantee correctness. What you can do is you can assure that the probability of success is at some level that's acceptable. So then the question is, what is considered to be acceptable? What's the risk that you're willing to accept in terms of collision versus hitting a pedestrian versus getting to your meeting late? And certainly those priorities are different. In order to make things safer, we would both like to take a more strategic view in terms of how do we drive and a more tactical view, right? And a lot of work right in autonomous vehicles right now is at a tactical level. And there's a very rich space to explore, and that rich space should understand a lot. Those technologies should understand a lot more about intent of the driver, intention of the drivers around you, and should understand what's considered to be acceptable risk and constantly reasoning in terms of that risk. Our problem is that we want to make driving both less stressful and safer, right? And so we want safety to be improved, right? And we want driving to be more relaxing. The cognitive overload, right, impacts both the relaxation and safety, so we want to reduce how much you have to think in terms of driving the car, and we want the transfer of control to the driver to be easier, right? So it is the case that we want a human to be able to engage, but if you engage by taking over the steering wheel, right, from sitting fully passive, right, then that's a big load for a driver to take over. So we'd like to be able to have a transfer of control between the driver and the vehicle where it requires less of a cognitive load, right, to be able to do that transition. At the same time, we would like to be able to have the driver to be immersed in the driving process, right, to some level. So not having them completely disengage and suddenly asked to fully take over. We'd like them to be partially engaged, and what it means to be take over means controlling at a higher level of distraction. Some issues that influence safety is lack of planning, being overly optimistic in terms of what you want to do. The driver's state can be distracted, right, because you didn't leave enough time. And then that's compounded with delays in traffic, road conditions, and unpredictable events. Those wouldn't be such an issue if you had left enough time and you weren't distracted. It just those things compound, right? So you set yourself up for failure. We want the system to be simple to interact with, but we want it to pay its attention to safety, right? And we want it to do that at the macro and the micro level. We want to do it for single vehicles and multiple. There's a lot of different kinds of decision-making capability that can help you, right? As long as you get the user interaction right. And I tried to give you one vision of how those technologies could be incorporated in a system, which as a travel advisor, both at the strategic level and the tactical level.